Always. You straight.
I love the way you stare. And feel you in my way. This is something you should have. Baby, would you do my head?
Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a tutorial on this makeup look. I wore it to the Greta Constantine 10th birthday party at Casaloma and I got a really great response, so I wanted to film a tutorial for you guys. Today I'm wearing false lashes, so I don't usually do that, but if I can do it, you can do it. So let's get to it. All right.
So the first thing I'm going to do is go in with my Laura Mercier foundation primer and apply it all over my face. This is going to make my skin look dewy as well as make my makeup last longer. Next, I'm going to take my MAC Painterly Paint Pot and a MAC 195 brush and build a base with it on my eyelid. This is going to stop your eyeshadow from moving around throughout the day as well as absorbing into your skin. I'm going to follow this with my Inglewood Paint Pot and using the same brush, I'm going to apply it to my lid and in my crease. The reason why I am doing this is because the eyeshadow we're going to be putting on top is similar in color. So if you rub your eye and wipe off some shadow, the bottom layer is a similar color and you can avoid any patchiness. Next, I'm going to use a bone color in my Tarte palette and a 217 brush and set that on my brow bone and above the crease to really help for ease and even blending later. Taking that same brush, I'm going to go into my Z palette and dip it into Orange Soda by ABH and use that as my transition color in and slightly above my crease. And I'm going to apply that using windshield washer movements back and forth. Now I'm going to take my Luxie small tapered blending brush and dip it into Sienna by ABH and place this directly in my crease to build depth to my transition. I'm going to start by placing it on my outer corner of my eye and start dragging the pigment inwards so that it's darkest in the outer corner and lightest in the inner corner. Again, I'm using windshield washer movements back and forth in those areas. Next, I'm going to use a Sephora eyeshadow brush and dip it into Ground Brown by MAC and build this up on my eyelid all the way up to my crease. I'm going to just really pack this on. When I put the copper tone on top later, you'll see how it really helps it stand out. Next, I'm going to take this MAC Loose Pigment in the color Quiver and apply it everywhere I just applied Ground Brown. If it's coming out too sheer, I recommend spritzing your brush with a little Fix Plus and then dipping again into the powder and packing it onto your lid. Another good dupe for this shadow is Henna by ABH. But like, look how good it looks. Oh, so nice. And just keep packing that on and bringing it up to your crease just to create like a really even and nice transition. And of course, I just can't stop, won't stop, so I'm just gonna keep going and applying that all over my lid until I can't see any brown anymore. So again, using my Luxie small tapered blending brush, I'm gonna dip that into Tempting and put that in my crease to help blend Quiver to Sienna. Now, taking my Kat Von D liquid eyeliner in the color Mad Max Brown, I'm going to start applying this at the base of my eyelashes to help define my lash line. This is also going to help hide the band of my false lashes later when I apply them. Now, before I start applying foundation, I'm just going to take a makeup wipe and clean up all the excess eyeshadow and fallout under my eyes. I'm also going to take this opportunity to define the shape in the outer corner. So for foundation, I'm currently using two foundations, the L'Oreal Infallible in Natural Buff and the Maybelline Fit Me in the color Porcelain. I'm going to mix those two on the back of my hand and apply that all over my face using a damp beauty blender. I'm just going to use bopping motions to help pixelate the pigment evenly and flawlessly all over my skin, including my jawline. I'm of course also going to do my forehead and any areas that are really, really red. I'm just going to go over them a little bit more. Again, just using that bopping motion the entire time. So now I'm going to use Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the color Light and apply that under my eyes in a triangle formation and a little bit on the side of my nose. This is going to make my nose appear skinnier later, so I like to do this. I'm also going to apply a little bit to my forehead and down my nose and of course a little bit on my chin. And I'm just going to take a beauty blender and pixelate that pigment evenly. I'm going to do it really softly under my eyes because your beauty blender is a sponge, so not only is it pixelating the pigment, but it's also picking up excess product. So if you don't press as harsh under your eyes, you leave behind more product and therefore have better coverage. Okay, so now I'm going to take my Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit and dip my Real Techniques setting brush into this color banana and set my concealer with it. I'm gonna put it under my eyes, on my forehead, down my nose, and on my chin. So pretty much everywhere that I put that concealer, I'm just gonna help set it, stop it from creasing, and give it that like nice flawless finish look. Okay, so now it's time to warm up the skin. So I'm going to bust out this Too Faced bronzer in the color Milk Chocolate, and using my Real Techniques 100 brush, I'm going to warm up my skin starting in the narrows of my cheeks, followed by my jawline and my temples and around my hairline. Don't forget to do a little bit on your neck too, so that everything is the same color and it's blended nicely. Okay, so now I'm going to contour and I'm going to use these two pigments from MAC. They are Sculpt C34 and Bone Beige B53. And taking a Real Technique sculpting brush, picking up a combination of both pigments and start applying that to the hollows of my cheeks. I really like using this brush to do this because you can really push up against your cheekbones and get right into the hollows of your cheeks, which helps really define that contour just the way you want it. I'm also going to contour my forehead and my temples and hair flip. So next, taking my NYX brow pencil in the color Ash Brown, I'm going to brush out my eyebrows, mainly focusing on brushing them up and over. Only after they are nicely brushed am I going to start building up my eyebrows with feather-like strokes and defining the shape. Small strokes allow you to imitate the appearance of hair, which will give you a more natural looking eyebrow. Also, the inner corner of your eyebrow should always be lighter than the middle and tail of your eyebrow, meaning that you should try and graduate from lighter to darker. Okay, so now I'm almost done with my brows. I'm just going to add some eyebrow gel to hold the hairs in place. Today I'm going to be using Give Me Brows by Benefit in the shade Light Medium, and I'm just going to brush that onto my brows. Next, I'm going to use a liquid highlighter on and above my cheekbones in dabbing motions. This one is by Temptu, but you can use any kind that you want. The reason why I do this is because any highlighter you put on top of a liquid highlighter becomes more intensified. So now I'm going to use my ABH highlighter in So Hollywood and my Morphe Mega Fan Brush and just apply that highlight over top. I'm also going to put some around my temples to soften the contour I put there earlier. Okay, now using my 214 brush, I'm gonna go back into that same ABH highlight and apply that under my eyebrows on my brow bone. I like doing this because it lifts the brow, making you look more awake. I'm also gonna apply that to my nose and on my Cupid's bow. I also forgot to contour my nose earlier, so I'm just gonna go and do that quickly. This is just gonna make my nose look a little bit more narrow. So using my MAC 129 brush, I'm going to dip that into my Tarte Cosmetics blush in Shimmering Peach and apply that to the apples of my cheeks. I really, really like this blush. It almost warms up my skin like a bronzer, but it's a blush. Okay, so now that I'm done with my face, I'm just going to finish off my eyes and use this Scone Smudger brush to apply some orange soda on the outer under corner of my eye and bring that in and around to the inner corner of my eye. Next, I'm going to use a MAC 212 flat definer brush and dip it into ground brown. I'm going to put this right up against my lower lash line. And then I'm going to go back in with my smudger brush and smudge that out so it blends nicely. I'm also going to go in again with Sienna and just blend that a little bit. Okay, so next I'm going to highlight the inner corner of my eye using this Josie Maran liquid eyeshadow in Playa del Pink. I'm going to use that Scone brush And I'm just going to put that on the inner corner of my eyes to give me a nice highlight. Now I want a pound of poontang until it stinks. You could be my mama and I'll be your boy. Original rude boy, never am I coy. You could be a shorty in my ill convoy. Not to come across. I'm then going to take the ABH So highlighter and just go over it so that it blends a little bit nicely. Because sometimes liquid eyeshadows can just be like blatant and harsh. Okay, so now I'm just going to spritz my face with Fix Plus before moving on. Now I'm going to tightline my eyes using this MAC Pro Longwear Eyeliner in Black Ice. This is going to define my lash line and make my eyes pop. After I'm done tightlining the bottom, I'm going to tightline a little bit of the top as well. So I'm going to just quickly curl my lashes before I pop my falsies on. Today I'm using House of Lashes Iconics, and I'm just going to quickly pop those on. If you're new at this, don't worry, just take your time. There we go, look at the difference. And I'm just going to start doing the other eye. So that Mad Max eyeliner we put on before is really going to help hide that lash band from your false lashes. Last thing we're going to do is apply mascara. This is going to darken your real lashes and help them blend slash stick to the false lashes. I lied, we still have lip gloss. So I'm just gonna use the NYX Butter Gloss in the color Creme Brulee and apply that to my lips. And that's it. Hello, hi there.
Hey guys, so that's the end of our tutorial. You made it. I hope it wasn't too difficult. If you have any comments, feel free to leave them down below. Otherwise, don't forget to subscribe and follow me on Instagram at Soheila Online, and I will see you next time. Bye. Keep bouncing.